Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Jordan Lee. Super excited collab coming your way right now on Heat's Love Island under the duvet. It's the queen of the internet, Molly-Mae! Queen of the internet.
I mean, I wouldn't go as far as say queen.
Oh, come on. But... like, your Instagram's gone up about like a gazillion since the last chat 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, it's been pretty crazy.
It is going up. Yeah. So what is it like? What's it like being outside the villa, back in real life?
It's crazy. Like, there's only one word to describe it and it would be crazy. It's just a whirlwind. Like, everyone comes out of the villa and like, you don't, you know, they can prepare you for it, but you never really know until you're out. And it's the truth. You don't know until you're out how crazy it's going to be. But it's been fun. I'm loving it.
While you were in the villa, you were predicted to be the most successful Love Islander, post Love Island.
Was I?
Yeah, that was a thing.
Oh my God, wow. Well,
how does that feel?
That feels great. I didn't know that. But yeah.
You know, but you're going to be like, I think, one of the busiest Love Islanders this year.
Yeah, I mean, I've been very busy already, but I like that. I love being busy. It's my thing. Like, I like to be busy. I'd rather be like crazy busy than absolutely doing nothing, laying in bed. So it's all good.
What's coming up then? Have you got anything?
So many exciting things. Like, obviously, so into fashion, so very excited fashion thing coming out very soon.
Is it a clothing line?
Potentially, you have to wait and see, but yeah, clothing related things coming out very soon, and hair stuff as well. I think whilst I was in there, my hair went pretty crazy.
Mad, I wanted a bun.
Yeah, I know, this whole bun thing went a bit viral. Like, bombshells would come in and they're like, you know, your bun's gone viral. I was like, has it? Just my bun. But yeah, so hair stuff coming out, like, it's all like, very exciting stuff.
And also, you were flying on a private jet.
Yeah, this has become quite a topic. Like, everyone seems to want to know about this jet.
But also, it's like the coolest thing ever, isn't it?
Yeah, it was fun. But we took off when the storm was happening, so you can imagine. Right. And it was like this, fearful for my life.
It was all good. Get your will in check now.
Literally,
I thought, honestly, I was bougie getting first class on a train. But you're like, you're just living it up. Is that like, is that when, like, it kind of hits reality, like, this stuff is just going to be your normal life?
I think so, yeah. I think there's been a few things where I've come out where it's like pinch me moments. It's like, oh my God, am I really doing this? And you do feel so unbelievably grateful that you do are open up to all these like opportunities and things when you come out. It's just, you have to do pinch yourself sometimes. Like, when I was getting on the jet, I was like, is this really happening? This is actually happening.
What's the biggest shock then been like outside the villa about like your daily life, like how it's changed?
I think it's just kind of adapting to like, obviously when you're going out and stuff, people want to like take your picture, people want to chat to you. But you know what I find is really nice? I thought people would come up and just ask you for a picture, but people come up and they're like, so how's the villa? Like, how's Tommy? Like, they actually want to have a chat with you, which I think is really nice.
Is that weird though, that they literally know everything about you and you've got to go like, yep, so how are you?
And sometimes people will come up to you and they just sort of stand in silence and they're like, hi. And like, you don't want to say, oh, do you want a picture? Because then it looks like you're saying, do you want to get a picture with me?
Yeah.
But then they're not asking anything. And it's kind of like, then I have to make a conversation with them. And it's like, so where are you from? And it's just, it's a bit awkward, but I'm getting used to it. It's fine.
What about people from your past then? Has anyone come out the woodwork and be like, oh, hey?
I've not really had that. I think like, that is kind of a predicted thing when you come out, that people will come out the woodwork and maybe like, try and be your friend and stuff. But I've not really had that. Like, all my friends that I had before have remained my friends. And no one's really tried to come out like, get on me or anything, so it's fine.
Not yet.
Yeah, not yet.
Oh, God. So we know you had a YouTube channel before you went in. You were obviously a hashtag influencer.
Yeah.
Like, was that always the kind of like thing to pursue, like being in the public eye?
And... well, I loved my job before I came in the villa. Mm. Like, it was my dream job. Like, I think a lot of people say, like, how do you get into influencing stuff? Like, I knew I wanted to do that. It was a path that I, like, went down. Mm. Because it is a job these days. Like, I know I think I got quite a lot of backlash when I went in about being an influencer and being, like, people trying to say, like, unemployed. But it is, like, I think people need to be a bit more, like, open-minded to the fact that it is a job now.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I moved out at 18 because of that job. Like, I got my own flat. Like, so it is a job. And I think it's sad that people are narrow-minded to it and don't respect it as a job when it really is, like, you know, in this day and age.
My mates who are influencers are the busiest people. Mm. Like, you know, they're like, oh, can we like see each other? You're like, yeah, in about 4 months.
Yeah,
time.
Yeah, like, book you in.
Yeah, you can maybe come to this event with me. And I'm like,
you are. And it's just as much the normal job that is anything else. And I know it kind of does get branded as like a bit of a fake job, but it's not. And I was so busy before I went in, and I wanted to just make sure I kept that job when I came out. And like, luckily with Love Island, it is kind of the job that you do carry on doing anyway. So for a lot of people, they're doing a new job as influencing, but really I'm just kind of doing my old job on a bigger scale.
You're like, step aside, guys. I know my thing. So what about you have got a bit of backlash online for, I still don't know why, because I think, you know, that's the kind of thing. How are you coping with that? How are you coping with, like, the social media hate?
I'm coping with it really well. I think there was rumours that came out about me being in therapy and stuff, yeah, which was just comical, because I was like, I was getting my makeup done, I was doing a photo shoot, and it was like, Molly-Mae in therapy. I was like, I'm just not in therapy. Like, I'm literally fine. I'm so happy. Like,
yeah.
I was just sitting there having the best time. I was thinking, it's crazy. The press will literally jump onto anything, but with the whole hate, like, I've literally been fine. Like, I just don't read it. Like, I think I typed my name in on Twitter once when I came out, read a few things, and I was like, okay, maybe let's not do that.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Maybe just don't search your name on Twitter, because, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think you know that it's going to be a thing when you come out. Not everyone's going to like you. And I think me in particular, I have got a lot of backlash, but not really for any real reason if you think about it. Like, there's not actually, I mean, people are branding me as fake, but I'm not. And I think people are seeing that now, so it's kind of, it has stopped.
And I think everyone, like, jumps on someone, especially on the series. Like, there's a couple that they'll just like, I mean, they call Michael the villain of the series, and that's kind of it now, and he's stuck with that.
So sad. Like, I think the whole trolling thing, like, the fact that it's still a thing now, you know, after, like, horrible things were happening in the past, you know, Love Island, it's so sad. It really is, and people aren't learning. Like, luckily, like, I've got very, very thick skin, but if I was more of a fragile person, things that they were saying about me, they could really affect me. Luckily, they don't, because I'm so happy and I'm in this bubble, and literally nothing could get to me right now. Yeah. But I think if I was a more, like, timid person, it could really, really get to you. Like, some of the things that people say are vile.
Yeah.
But, you know, you just have to kind of brush it off, and I am so happy right now. It's like, you are in this bubble and nothing can burst it. It's cringy.
Are you checking in with yourself, though? Like, you know, having a treat yourself moment?
Yeah. I've been definitely, like, looking after myself. I had a little facial the other day. It's all good, it's all nice. Like, it's busy, but you have to make sure that you're looking after yourself at the same time. Like, I want to start going back to the gym and to, like, eat healthy, because you can get really carried away.
Yeah.
And it's that bubble, and, like, start eating McDonald's for breakfast, lunch and dinner, and it's like, I really can't be a thing.
It's too much. Honestly, I think some of the guys, like George and Tom and stuff, they've literally been like, especially George, with his, like, snacks.
Oh my god, yeah, he's literally snacks.
Like, I need to go to the gym.
Did you see us eating in the villa, like, all the time? All we ever did in there was eat, like, toasties, crisps, biscuits, chocolate. Like, we were just like, can we get some chocolate, please? Like, I used to just be eating all the time.
Yeah.
Something to do, pass the time.
Oh, right. I want to see then, and take a second to actually see how much your life has changed, like, before the villa and after the villa.
Okay.
Right, so I've got some questions, including,
fire away.
How many followers did you have before entering the villa?
So before I went into the villa, I had 160,000 followers.
And what are we on now?
Yeah, nearly 3.1.
What is that like?
It's crazy. Like, I remember I refreshed my phone when I got my phone back, and I was like, this isn't my account. Like, this is someone else's account, but it is crazy.
Yeah, what is the craziest thing you were gifted as an influencer before entering the villa?
Oh, like, God,
the coolest thing?
That's a really hard one. Like, in a bougie way, you do get gifted stuff every day. Like, people just want to send you as much as they can, like, try and test out their products on you in the hope that you'll put it on your socials. So you do, like, there wasn't not one thing that pops out, but, like, clothing, just constant clothes, which is great for me because I'm obsessed with clothes.
Yeah. What about now? Is there one thing you're like, oh my God?
Well, I guess going on the jet was very exciting.
Relaxing. How often were you recognised before being in the villa? Because obviously you were still an influencer.
Yeah, do you know, when I went out in Manchester, like, when I was out shopping, people did used to come up to me. It was more for my YouTube. People were like, watch my YouTube and I get a selfie. You know, that was so weird back then. I used to get so buzzing because I was like, oh my God, I've only got 40,000 subscribers, so people know who I am.
Yeah.
So that was like, a few times I used to get stopped in Manchester, but...
And obviously now you literally can't walk down the street without...
It's crazy. Sometimes, like, it's weird though. Sometimes you'll go like 2 hours without getting seen at all, but then sometimes you'll have 5 minutes where, like, 100 people will come up and queue waiting for a selfie in a shop and stuff.
Queuing.
Yeah, it's strange.
Does that, like, give you a bit of, like, anxiety at all, that kind of thing? Or is it just like you're taking it in your stride?
No, like, it's nice. Like, apart from when you have to have those awkward conversations with people that just stand there, like I said, and they don't really say anything. But apart from that, like, it's all fine. I enjoy it.
All right. Most famous person in your phone before you enter the villa?
I don't know. Like,
don't know.
No, just like influencer friends, like A-list, like, what was it? When they're like reality stars, what is that, like I said? What is that?
You said it.
What is it?
Well, you could, I mean, there's many alphabetical letters. I mean, you choose your one.
Yeah, well, yeah, like, but reality those ones, stars and stuff.
Anyone now that you're like, oh my God, I can't believe?
Well, I guess, like, obviously, like, Big Love Island as well. Like, got Curtis's phone number, got Maura's phone number. You know, I guess to other people, that'd be very exciting, so.
All right, finally, did you believe in love before entering the villa?
Yeah, I did believe in love before. I've been in love before.
Right.
But, like, now, it's just really not. I didn't expect to find it. Like, you know when you go to Love Island, you think, I'm going to find love, but I wasn't sure. And I think because I wasn't looking for it as deeply as everyone else, I think that's why I found it.
Mm.
Like, I always say, when you stop searching for something really hard, like, you always find it. And I think, because I wasn't, like, really, really desperate, like, I'm going to find it. Tommy walked in, and I think that's why I found it.
That is where I've been going wrong for 25 years.
Stop looking for it.
I can't, honestly.
Stop.
Just on all
way.
The apps and no,
no
one's matching with
delete
me.
Them.
So how's Tommy?
He's great. He's in bed by now, asleep.
Yeah, apparently he surprised you.
Yeah, he did. Mm. Last night it was so cute. I had a little knock on the hotel door and he was there. He was in Manchester and he came and surprised me.
Oh my god.
But I think it's so cool because we're trying to make time for each other. Like, yeah. Obviously we're so busy, but it's so essential that you do make that time for each other.
And are you doing a lot separately and then, like, obviously the time together?
Yeah. We have a lot of separate things going on. Like, obviously he's got his projects he's working on. I've got mine. Mm. Projects that I'm working on, and I think when we have the time, we're just going to make sure we spend it together.
Yeah. 100%. So 54 days in the villa with him, 2 weeks out. Are we thinking about moving in yet?
It's been spoken about. Yeah. I think I've got a place in Manchester, so I think he'll probably live with me in Manchester for a bit. And we were even thinking about maybe him getting a place in London, me keeping my place in Manchester, and when we need to be in each place, we'll just be in those places together. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So there's a lot of options, but yeah, it's all very exciting.
Oh my god, that's exciting. Well, Curtis last week was on and he said about marriage and kids with Maura.
Really?
Straight
wow,
up.
Wow, bring those ones out already.
I know. Yeah. Is there any plans like that yet?
I mean, that is very a bold statement to make. I mean, Tom and I are only 20. I turned 20 in lockdown, like I only just turned 20. So I think to be speaking about marriage and kids is scary.
Yeah.
But it's, maybe one day. Who knows?
Watch this space.
Yeah, literally.
So some of your fans, like we were saying, they're deep sleuthers. They go deep into everything and anything that's posted. Like, they saw that Tommy's changed his phone background to that, like, gorgeous photo of you. Have you changed your background to him?
Mine is a picture of him and me together. But it was so funny because it was literally just he just moved his phone like that. You couldn't even see it. And all these fan accounts were like, oh my God, Molly's his screensaver. They managed to see it, but it was so quick. It was just like the phone went like that and they screenshotted it. These fan accounts are crazy.
Also in the villa, you didn't know what both of you were going to save each other in your phones. So if you made a decision.
It's just Tommy with an it's cute.
Super simple.
Super simple.
All right, we've got to talk a little bit about Tommy at the reunion and those shoes that he was wearing and also the size of the feet.
Yeah, like everyone's calling him both feet or like clown feet.
Clown feet!
I think the shoes are absolutely unreal, don't you think?
Mm.
I think they're unreal, but yeah, his feet. He's got like size 12, 11 or 12, I think.
Damn.
Big feet. Big feet. You know what they say about big feet?
Yeah. You having a good time?
Yeah, I agree. But yeah, the shoes, I mean, in one of the pictures, they look literally about this long, which is just funny, but...
Also, you're so petite, it's just like, it just elongates this even more.
Just the boat feet just chilling on the canal.
But the rumours are still persisting about, like, you guys not being real. That must just, like, be annoying, hurt, like, what's the...
It is, like, it does really frustrate me seeing it. I think people commenting on the pictures, like, don't know, something about her still just feel like she's being fake, and it's like... I don't know, I can't do anything.
No.
There's nothing I can do, it can only be me. And the most important thing that I say every single time is that Tommy knows how I feel. And that is literally all I care about.
Yeah.
So like, my family know, the islanders know, like not one islander came out of the villa and said, Molly's fake. They've all said they're the most genuine couple. She's so real, like they're besotted by each other. And I think people are still not listening to that. The fact that the people that lived with us for 8 weeks cannot believe that this is being said.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, Anna literally came out and was like, this is so ridiculous, but people still, I think they just want to jump on anything.
Yeah.
They just want to find that one thing, one couple, one person to really just tear down. But unfortunately, it's not going to tear us down.
Well, we had Curtis on again last week, and he did say about the final, and he thinks deep down you thought you were going to win.
Did he say that?
Yeah.
Curtis.
I know, naughty boy.
No, do you know what I always say to people? That when you're in there, you have no idea what the public are saying about you at the end of the day. Like, for all I know, like, they could have absolutely hated me and Tommy. Like, they could have hated me, they could have hated Tommy. You don't know. So you don't know who's gonna win. No one knows that. And I guess, like, people would come in and be like, oh, we think you're gonna win because, you know, you're the only two that are in love. As the show just showed, it doesn't matter.
No.
You could be in there for 2 days, a week, the whole time, you can still win.
Yeah.
Like, Greg showed that. So no, I didn't think I was gonna win. Tommy didn't think we were gonna win. It wasn't like that at all. It was just,
apparently,
people predicted it.
Like, apparently Tommy thought he was going to go like every single like day.
Yeah,
like, oh,
every single time there was a dump, he was like, we're going. I was like, just come back, smile. You don't know that, yeah.
But also you did kind of win because you found Tommy.
Well, that's what I said. Like, I always say we won in our own way because we found each other. And it sounds really cringy, but when we came second, we came off stage and we went to the side and we had this really nice moment where I just kind of looked at him and was like, we didn't need to win that to like prove that we found each other. We've won. Like, this is our prize. We found each other. It does sound so cringy, but we didn't need
but
to win.
But it's nice.
It is nice. Like, and it's so true. Like, we didn't need to win that final to prove that like we were the like kind of the winners in a way because we fell in love. So it was, I won in my own way. It's all good.
Damn, girl.
Yeah.
So after the final came the reunion. And that was just, it was just a little bit awkward all around, wasn't it?
I think I really suffered at the reunion a little bit. I mean, Anton kind of obviously went in a little bit, but it's done now. Like, yeah. it was.
People were saying he was just a bit harsh. Like, do you agree with that?
I guess, but it's not really, like, it wasn't a big deal. Like, so he unfollowed on Instagram, it doesn't really matter. Like, at the end of the day, you know, people are entitled to follow and unfollow who they want to do that too. So I did not think about it for 1 minute. It was fine.
We should teach him that there is a mute feature.
There is a mute. But you know, he savaged it and went full way and unfollowed, so that's absolutely fine.
Also, did you tell him to F off at the reunion?
No.
You know, everyone was
oh my gosh, I know. I saw this headline and I was like, oh my god, if this actually looks like I did say F off, I'll be really annoyed. And I said, that's fine. Like, let me mouth that. Does that look like F off? No. Do you think?
It's fine.
Oh, it's fine, whatever. It's fine.
But you're still following him, aren't you?
Yeah. And I won't be unfollowing him. Like, I don't.
He's gonna dare you to unfollow him.
No, I just think, like, it's not me. Like, I'm like, he's my friend. Like, I genuinely, there's no bad blood there. Like, I did not have an issue with Anton. I wasn't aware that he had an issue with me.
Yeah.
So that's why I was shocked when it all kind of came about that he'd unfollow me. But what can you do?
Yeah.
It's fine. I'm not everyone's cup of tea, and that's absolutely fine.
Exactly. Are you still keeping in touch with all the other islanders then? Like, the group chat going off? Or?
The group chat is not going off. Like,
really?
There's really not that much chat on the chat. There's not much chat on the chat. Yeah, I think there was at the start a little bit. Mm. More people saying, oh, I'm in this club, so anyone want to come here? And people were like, yeah, I'll be there in a bit. But that was it, really. Like, the chat's not been that active. But I think what's happened is people have kind of formed their own friendship group.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they kind of just, like, split off. Because, in a way, you're not going to be close with, like, 40 people.
No.
From, like, different backgrounds, different, like, personality types. It's just not,
yeah.
You're not, it's, you know, it's just not the way it works.
And also, people seem to be, like, doing a little, like, there's a bunch of them in Ibiza right now, and then, like, some people are just at home. Like, it's all, you're all just doing different stuff.
Yeah, yeah. And, like, that's fine. But that's okay, though, because, like, when in the real world would you be friends with 40 people? It's just not, it wouldn't be that way. So
no.
It's fine. I think it's fine that everyone's kind of doing their own thing. And, like, it was expected. Like, I knew it was going to happen when people came out.
And you're so busy anyway, so it doesn't really matter, do you?
Don't even sometimes have time to see Tommy, let alone, like, meet up with every single person. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think that's just the way it is. And people all, like, everyone understands that. So it's fine.
We're still mates for life. It's fine.
Yeah. Of course.
Molly-Mae, everyone! Right, before we finish, because you are the queen of the internet, I'm going with that. You have to take it now, put it in your bio,
right,
that's what will happen.
Okay.
You do also have hundreds of thousands of subscribers on YouTube, and, you know, I think this is a perfect time to do a bit of a collab with you.
Okay.
Because, you know, my massive audience of 164 people would, you know, love that kind of thing.
Wow, okay.
So we've got you a bit of a haul.
Oh, okay, cute.
So I love it if you could teach me how to do, like, an A-star haul.
Absolutely, I can do that.
Cool, all right. We're gonna do it. Right, I will warn you now, this is not probably the kind of stuff you normally
do. That's fine.
But here we go. So here's your little hat.
Okay. What the hell?
Do you remember them?
I remember these. Don't they grow or something?
And they're like pregnant or... I hated them in school.
Oh my god, that's so weird. Okay, should we do this then?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, cool, right. So I'll be like, hi guys, welcome back to my channel, it's Molly-Mae, Bunny Blah, all that good stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
So do a little intro.
Yeah.
So today, I have to show you this really, really exciting alien egg. So you have to basically big it up.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Big it up. Like, as you can see, like, this is really handy. You can use it, like, day to day. Don't know how, but you can.
I love this kind of, like, emerald green scenario we've got going on.
Yeah, really, really nice deep green. Would really, like, bring out people's eyes. You know, next to them.
Really nice, really considering nice. His...
Like, feels really good quality, like, not like really good, nice quality there.
Yeah.
This retails for about $9.99. So, nice price, you know, good gift for someone.
I love it. Kind of looks like a beauty blender, but I definitely
kind of
use it
like a beauty blender. Maybe you could use it multi-purpose.
Love it. This is a market waiting to be open.
Literally, yeah. So, there we have the alien egg for you guys.
Ooh. Absolutely love it. That was so pro.
Yeah, I mean, I've never had to haul an alien egg. Is that what you call an alien egg?
Alien, I don't know. Is that the name of it? I think so. There was one thing in here.
Alien thing.
I think, oh my god, don't open it.
Okay, sorry.
You literally look so glam, please don't put that on. There is one thing in here though that we thought was really cute, and it kind of looks a bit like Ellie Belly.
Oh my gosh, everyone's gone mad for Ellie Belly.
Is that weird?
It is so weird, because honestly, my mum, before I went in, I was packing Ellie Belly, she was like, you can't take Ellie Belly, that's so embarrassing. And the first time I went into the villa, I hid Ellie Belly under the quilt.
Yeah.
Because I was so humiliated that everyone was like, what the hell is that? But by day two, everyone had seen him, and I was like, there's no going back now, he's out there. He's out there, and then people were starting to borrow him and stuff, like when they were down, they were like, have Ellie Belly tonight. I was like, you were mugging him off at the start.
What are you playing?
And now you want to hug him, so.
I think the best bit was when you and Tommy were in bed, and then you know when they did the little captions? And they did Ellie Belly, and I was like, oh, he's part of the fam.
I thought you were going to say when Ellie Belly fell off the bed.
Oh my god, iconic as well.
We don't talk about that.
Oh my god, poor child.
I know.
Oh god. But yeah, how cute is that?
This is so cute. It smells good too.
I know, it's great.
Bath bomb, yeah.
There you go. I love that. Is that a bath bomb?
Yeah, I don't know. A soap.
Soap bar.
Soap.
I don't really want to be rubbing Ellie Belly on me though.
No, no, definitely not. He needs a good wash.
I see.
Yeah, he needs a good wash.
You're not like one of those.
Not for that reason.
You're not one of those people that have like multiple ones and like you wash them in and out.
Yeah, but everyone wanted to hug Ellie Belly. Like when they were down or crying or anything, they were like, yeah. Oh, Ellie Belly. I was like, it's really become a thing. Yeah, it's so cute.
Get him his own Instagram account.
Yeah, he needs. I think I might make one. You know, there's been a lot of like, fan accounts for Ellie Belly, but I might make the official
original.
And try
get
and get
verified.
Rooted.
Yeah.
Yeah, try and get.
Easy. Oh my god, well thank you very much. That is Molly-Mae, everyone. That is it for this week's Under the Duvet. Make sure you check out this week's Heat magazine for all the latest of the couples of this year at heatworld.com/Love Island for all the breaking stuff outside of the villa. Do you want to do this bit because you're really good at it?
Yes,
we'll say.
Make sure you like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to the channel, and hopefully we will see you all in our next one.
She's a pro!